And this section is on complex fractions. And it's also a review of the order of operations. So let's talk about what a complex fraction is. So a complex fraction looks like this. And it's essentially any fraction that has a fraction as the numerator or as the denominator, or both. So the numerator and or the denominator contain fractions. And in this fraction, you can see that the numerator is x over 4, that's a fraction, and the denominator is 3/2, that's also a fraction. So that would constitute a complex fraction. So there's a couple of ways to simplify that, so we're going to talk about both methods. We're going to call the first one method 1. And method 1 says that we need to rewrite the fraction as division. So let me show you what that looks like. Say we have the complex fraction 7y over 10 over 1/5. That's a complex fraction, because we just said complex fractions have the numerator, denominator, or both as fractions, right? So we're going to write this as division, keeping in mind that this fraction bar really means division. So I can rewrite it as 7y over 10 divided by 1 over 5. And we know how to do that because we know how to divide fractions from previous sections. So how do we divide two fractions? Yep. So keep the first fraction the same. Change division to multiplication. And find the reciprocal of the second fraction. There you go. Okay, remember the trick for reducing before you even start? You can multiply and then reduce, but I'm just going to reduce it before I start. So I can divide 5 by 5 and 10 by 5. So I get 7y over 2. If you multiply all the way through and reduce at the end, you're going to get the same answer. So we call that method 1. Let's talk about method 2. Method 2, we are going to multiply by the LCD of all the fractions. So let's work with the same complex fraction. Let's work with 7y over 10 all over 1/5. So the first thing I have to do is figure out what the LCD is for my top fraction and my bottom fraction. So what is the LCD between 10 and 5? 10. My LCD is 10. So I'm going to multiply the top fraction and the bottom fraction by the LCD. So I'm going to multiply this one by 10 and this one by 10. So let's see what happens when we do that. When we do that, then the top fraction becomes 10 times 7y over 10. And the bottom fraction becomes 10 times 1 over 5. Okay, let's look at the numerator. What's that?
When the denominator, the bottom part is 10.
Oh, no, it would be 5, because it's 10 over 1 times 1 over 5. So I'm multiplying the top fraction by 10 and the bottom fraction by 10, not 10 over 10. Okay, so what happens here, and this is the reason we do this, these two 10s are going to cancel out, and I'm going to be left with just 7y on the top. And this 10 and this 5 are going to get reduced. What's 10 divided by 5? 2, so I get just 2 at the bottom. And if you notice, I get the same answer here that I got up there. Just a different way of doing it. Questions? So I'll do one using both methods so we can get a little accustomed to it. So let's do an example. Let's say we want to simplify 1/2 plus 1/6 over 3/4 minus 2/3. Okay, so let's try method one first. So what was method one? Write it as division. So I'm going to write the top divided by the bottom. So I'm going to write 1/2 plus 1/6 divided by 3/4 minus 2/3. And I'm also going to write parentheses around the top and the bottom so that I know I'm dividing the top by the bottom, not just the two middle fractions. Okay, now I use what I know about adding fractions to add what's inside the parentheses. So how do I add 1/2 plus 1/6? So I want to add this first part right here.
Find the LCD.
Yeah, so what's the LCD between 1/2 and 1/6?
6.
So I'm going to multiply this fraction by 3. So this fraction becomes 3 over 6 plus 1 over 6. I'm just going to work on the first one really quick, and then I'll work on the second one in a second. All right. So 3 over 6 plus 1 over 6 is 4 over 6. I'm going to leave it like that for now. Okay, let's work on the second fraction. What is my LCD so I can subtract these two fractions? Yes. So I need to multiply the first fraction by 3, and I need to multiply the second fraction by 4. So the first fraction becomes 9 over 12, and the second fraction becomes 8 over 12. Do I need to break down anything I've done so far? Okay. And then what's 9 over 12 minus 8 over 12? 1 over 12. Okay. I'm at this point, so now I need to divide the two fractions. How do I divide two fractions? Yeah, we just did that a second ago, and it's basically keep the first number the same, change the division sign to a multiplication sign, and flip the second fraction. And I'm going to reduce. 12 divided by 6 is 2. So my answer over here is 4 times 2, which is 8. Questions about any of those steps? So I'm going to try the same problem using method 2 now. Got it? So let's use method 2 to work on the same problem. So the problem was 1/2 plus 1/6 divided by 3/4 minus 2/3. What did method 2 say to do? Find the LCD of all the fractions. So what is the LCD of 2, 6, 4, and 3? The LCD is 12. Okay? So I'm going to multiply the top fractions by 12 and the bottom fractions by 12 as well. So I'm going to multiply these by 12 and these by 12. Okay? So this is basically the distributive property. So if I distribute this 12, I get 12 times 1 over 2 plus 12 times 1 over 6 over, let's work on the bottom fractions now. Again, I'm going to distribute it using the distributive property. So the first becomes 12 times 3 over 4, and the second one becomes minus 12 times 2 over 3. Questions so far about how I got there? All right, now I'm just going to reduce. So I can reduce over here. What's 12 divided by 2? So this reduces to 6. Here I can reduce 12 divided by 6. 12 divided by 6 is 2. So the top becomes 6 plus 2. Let's look at the bottom. If I reduce this, I can decide to reduce the 12 and the 4. Reduces into 3. And the 12 and the 3 reduces into 4. So 3 times 3 is 9. Oh, that was a minus. I keep putting plus. And 4 times 2 is 8. So what happened when I multiplied by the LCD? Why would I want to do that? What was my advantage to multiplying by the LCD? Hey, what? All the numbers actually go away. So notice we had 2 and 6, and they went away so that we had a whole number in the top. So the advantage to multiplying by the LCD is that all your denominators are cleared, and you only have whole numbers when you're done. So we're here now, and that's easy to simplify. 6 plus 2 is 8. 9 minus 8 is 1. So the answer is 8. So I'll have one for you to try now. So try 3/4 over x over 5 minus 1. Let me give you the answer before you start, so you can check your work. The answer is 15 over 4x minus 20. So go ahead and try it, using whichever method you like.